So have you found any problem in yesterday's lecture? The paper which we have discussed. So have you tried to recollect what we have discussed yesterday? Anyone? Trupti? Sandhya? ओके ओके
परत एकदा रिव्हिजन
रिव्हिजन ओके सो लेट्स वी विल स्टार्ट विथ अनदर पेपर ओके दैट पेपर आई विल शेअर इज दिस विजिबल टू यू
येस सर
येस सर
ओके ओके This is the paper from JOC. JOC means Journal of Organic Chemistry. Again, the very interesting paper. Let me see. Green. Not possible to write on here. Okay, so this JOC means Journal of Organic Chemistry, and which is this paper is published through American Chemical Society Journal, very reputed journal, having impact factor is more than 10. Okay, so maybe in initial introductory lecture in MSc first year, I have already discussed about the impact factor and so on. Okay. So now I will not repeat, we will go through directly the content part. So the case study of this paper also we have to do. Here the title of this paper is Nigramide AS, A2S actually this one, okay. It will start from letter A to letter S. So how many compound will be there? From A. Like A, B, C, D, E, F, G up to S. Okay. Then dimeric amide alkaloids from the roots of pipernigrum. Now this pipernigrum is familiar to you. The pipernigrum root they have used to extract and isolated some amide type of alkaloids and which is dimeric alkaloids. Okay. And how many they are? A to S. Then who has published the paper? There are three... four, five scientists or researchers are there. Few of them from Japan, the Toho University, and the few of them from Shenyang Pharmaceutical University, China. Okay, so he is the star author, or whole responsibility belongs to this paper is this person, Tamotsu Naikaido. Okay, and he will be the first author, Kun Y. Okay, he has worked more and these all are the co-authors. Okay, why I am discussing this? Because this word should be familiar with you. You are going to start your project work. Very soon you will register for the PhD and research. So you should know these things, right? So this is the one basic backbone of this alkalamide. The number one, which is nigramide A. Okay, so the 15 novel dimeric amides, they have isolated alkaloids processing a cyclohexene ring. So see, this is the middle part having the cyclohexene type of ring and called as nigramides A to O. So from A letter to up to O means 15 are there, as well as four novel dimeric amides alkaloid processing cyclobutane. Rather than this cyclohexene ring, here you will find cyclobutane type of structure. And like that cyclobutane alkalamides, which is nigramides from P to S. So the number is from 17 to 20.
Number
Yes, yes. A means 1, so O means 15, like that. P means 17, so S means 20. Right. So their structures were elucidated on the basis of their spectroscopic data. The biosynthesis hypothesis of nigramides A2O was proposed by an intermolecular Diels-Alder reaction. So how they have prepared this type of alkalimide is using this reaction, which is Diels-Alder reaction. Okay, from the corresponding monomeric amides, on the basis of this biosynthetic hypothesis, the first study of the thermal and Lewis acid mediated Diels-Alder reactions of piperine in different organic solvents and under solventless conditions is described. So this is the abstract of this paper. Okay, and let's start with introductory part. Who will willingly wants to read up to these two paragraph only from here to here?
Yes, sir.
Yes, please.
The genus Piper, Piperaceae, has over 700 species widely distributed in the tropical and subtropical regions of the world. Among them, Piper nigrum is one of the most well-known species because of its high commercial, economic, and medicinal importance. Its period, its ripened fruit is the source of white pepper, while the unripe fruit is the source of black pepper. Biological investigations of Piper nigrum have been mainly aimed at piperine, the main constituent of the plant, which has central nervous system, depressant, anti-inflammatory.
Okay. Thank you. So, in introductory part, they have given the history of why they have synthesized and what is the uses, what are the commercial, economical, and medical importance of this Piper nigrum. Okay, and they have shown that this Piper nigrum is very important for the central nervous system as a depressant, anti-inflammatory, and hepatoprotective, intestinal permeability properties. Okay, so which is, in short, which is bioactive type of compounds. The fruit of Piper nigrum has been extensively investigated for its chemical constituents and occurrence of amide alkaloid, which already we have seen that the properties of amide alkaloids. Okay, so this is all about the introduction they have given up to here, the introductory part. Then what they have done in this paper. So yes, who is the next willing to read up to only this paragraph? Please continue. Okay, so our continuing photochemical study of this extract. So author is writing like this, okay. LED to isolation of 21 bis alkaloids from 1 to 21, of which 1 to 16 were determined to be cyclohexene type, and 70 to 21 to be like cyclobutene type of dimeric amide alkaloid. Means there are two type of alkaloids are there. So among them, 16 and 21 are known compounds. Other, to best of our knowledge, except for 16, the dimeric amide alkaloids family possessing a cyclohexene ring has not been reported to date. In this paper, we described the isolation and structural elucidation of novel compounds 1 to 15 and 17 to 20 on the basis of their spectroscopic data. Okay, so almost 21 compounds are there. So out of that, how they have isolated. So you can see here isolation part. The air-dried roots of Piper nigrum were extracted with methanol, and the extract was successively partitioned with chloroform, ethyl acetate, and butanol. The chloroform soluble fraction was subjected to normal phase and reverse phase silica gel column chromatographies followed by C18HPLC to afford compounds 1 to 21. And then they have begin with the structural elucidation of compound A. Okay, A to 15 totally. And they have mentioned, started to read about the compound 1 first. Okay, so this is the all explanation of compound 1 from here to this, up to this. Okay, so all discuss about only compound 1. Then again, this paragraph is also on compound 1 up to here. Okay, so whatever they have mentioned is only for the compound 1. And then they have started from compound 2 and so on. So we'll discuss about the structure of this compound 1. They have given here the list of compounds, the structures, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, up to 15. See here, up to 16, there is cyclohexene type of ring in between, okay? You can see clearly, 1, 2, 3, is 16 parent. And from 17, you can see there is a cyclobutane type of ring in between, okay? So from 17 to 21. So like this 21 structure, they have elucidated from this spectroscopic technique. So for a case study, we will discuss about the compound 1 first. I will share the PPT. Okay, so this is the structure. You can see the PPT now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, okay. Great. Yes. See, this is the compound 1 having this cyclohexene type of ring in between. Okay, so from here, can I change the color? Pink color, yes. Okay, so see here, where is the number 1, numbering 1? Okay, so see, this carbon is number 1, this carbon is number 2, this carbon is number 3, here is number 4, here is number 5, number 6, number 7, number 8, number 9, 10, and 11. Right? So up to 11, they have given numbering like this. Then for this number, this side, this is 1 dash, this is 2 dash, 3 dash, 4 dash, and 5 dash. Okay, on this side. Then they have started from here, this carbonyl carbon is 1 double dash, 2 double dash, here 3 double dash, this carbon, okay? Then 4 double dash, 5 double dash, 6 double dash, 7 double dash, 8 double dash, and 9 double dash. Then this remaining, 1 triple dash, 2 triple dash, 3 triple dash, 4 triple dash, and 5 triple dash. So how many carbons are there? 11 are first one, then single dash, 5, then double dash,
30.
Double dash, how many? 9.
9.
Okay. Triple dash, how many? Again, 5. So 11, 9, 20, and 30. So total 30 carbons are there. I think here is one carbon. So here is one. The numbering is not given. Again, here is one. Another. So I think 32 carbon compound is there, or something remain? Okay, so at least we'll understand the what is the numbering of this type of compound. Then the same way there is a numbering for compound 2. You can see correctly they have started from again this number 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Right? Then 1, 2, 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, 4 dash, 5 dash. Then here is 1 double dash, 2, 2, 3 double dash, 4, 5, here 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Correct. And then 1 to 5. Triple dash. Okay, accordingly. So same with compound 3, same with compound 4. This is compound 4 and this is 5. Okay, accordingly. So you can take any one compound and try to recollect data. Okay, now the next part is about the carbon 13 and proton NMR. So I will move in the paper and then let's see. Where it is? Yes. Okay. So now this is the general compound. And where they have given the description of compound 1. Okay, this one. So, see, common name is nigramide. Common name is nigramide now. I think this nigram, from nigram they have taken N-I-G-R and this is amide. Okay, so total is nigramide. And A means compound 1, B means compound 2, C means like that. Okay. So was obtained as a colorless oil, which did not give crystals suitable for X-ray analysis. Its HRFA BMS exhibited a pseudomolecular ion peak, which is 545. And this is molecular peak. And molecular weight is calculated accordingly. Consistent with the molecular formula, yes. See, we have confirmed how many carbon atoms are there? 32.
30.
Right? And then hydrogen 36, nitrogen 2, and oxygen 6. So, and 16 degree of unsaturation. So, degree of unsaturation, I think you have already studied the spectroscopy. So, you will understand. Right? Then its IR absorptions implied the presence of carbonyl peak. So this is the very important peak of IR, which is belongs to carbonyl. Okay, the proton NMR spectrum of 1 displayed 2 sets of aromatic protons due to 2 1 3 4 trisubstituted aromatic ring. 1 3 4 trisubstituted aromatic ring A and C at delta so and so and so, these are the values. The proton NMR spectrum also exhibited signals of cis olefin at this, and then so on. Okay, they have already discussed in table 1. Then besides the above mentioned moiety analysis, H1 quasi spectrum also define other spin systems. A cyclohexene ring and 2 piperidine rings B and D as shown in figure 1. Where is figure 1? I think is this. This is table 1. This is figure 1. Oh my god. So this is the quasi spectrum. Who has coupled with whom and the quasi means the environment. Okay, so what type of environment is there and who has coupled with whom, like that. So see this carbon, having two hydrogen, and this hydrogen is coupled with this hydrogen here or carbon, and this hydrogen is coupled with this carbon. Like that, all quasi they have already given here. Figure one. In the HMBC spectrum, the two methylene dioxy compound were located at rings A and C based on the long range connectivities. Okay, so they have, in this paragraph, they have explained everything about the carbon 13 proton NMR of each peak and why they have coupled, why their peaks are like that, what is the quasi, what is the correlation with no Z, and so on up to here. Right? Then also they have explained about the configuration of four stereogenic centers of one, very elucidated on the stereogenic center means what type of center? Chiral. Okay, chiral center. So center were elucidated on the basis of 1H, 1H coupling constant and Nozick correlation as shown in figure 2, computer generated 3D drawing. So that is also there. This one. Selected Nozick correlation. So same compound they have, what we can say to this type of compound, this is computer generated study. Okay, and what is the impact of these on these, this hydrogen to this hydrogen to this, and so on. Okay. Then, where is computer generated figure 3D drawing? The coupling constant, where L11 and 9 respectively indicating the anti-relations of, means for spectroscopy study, this paper is very important. Okay, so you can take any one compound to study it and characterize it very well. Okay, so whatever characterization is there, try to recollect all data, why this sentence has written, and so on. So take the help of your spectroscopy teacher as well. Then coupling constant. Then furthermore, since the optical rotation was zero and the circular dichroism, because to calculate this optical rotation again, another CD spectrum we have to study. And it exhibited no quaternary effect. So what is quaternary effect? As an exam point of view also is very important. Was found to be a racemate type of mixture. On the basis of the above spectral data, the structure of nigramide A was unambiguously established. This is all about the compound A. And again, the spectrum, if I have taken this, so from 1 to 11, these are the values. Then 1 dash to 5 dash, these are the values. Then 2 dash to 9 dash here in second batch. 2 dash to 9 dash and third 1 dash to 5 dash. So all proton NMR values, carbon 13 values are there. And remaining the values, they have included in the table number 2. From compound 2 to, it will start from compound 2, 3, 4, 5, then 2 dash, 3 dash, and 5 dash. Here, okay. So here is again 2 to up to 24 compound number. And then the carbon 13 also the same. 2 to 15 here. The data for compound 2 to 15. Then the discussion of each one of the compound. Then which H1 enumer of the 17 number of compound. Which one? Only 17 number. Why is wrong? Okay, 17 number. 17 number means this is again the detail which they have provided, because 17 number compound will have cyclobutane ring inside. Okay, cyclobutane rather than cyclohexane. So this is the numbering is different than that compound. First compound. Then the name of that one is nigramide P. Okay. And then from 17 to 21 or 24 up to 24 is given here. Then the values, yes, this is mass spectroscopy analysis of compound 19 having cyclobutane inside and this type of structure. Then the scheme, in this scheme you can see clearly the starting material is dialkyl type. Then there will be what type of reaction? This one?
Diels-Alder reaction.
This is Diels-Alder reaction. Okay. Here four pi electron will involved, and here two pi electron will involved, and there will be a formation of cyclohexene type of ring. So it's called as 4+2 cycloaddition. I think we have studied the photochemistry.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes, yes.
We have already studied the photochemistry with us.
Yes, sir.
Yes. So in photochemistry, we have studied this 4+2 cycloaddition reaction, which is Diels-Alder reaction. Okay. So this is cyclohexane ring. Then this is the actual structure, and based on this actual structure, you can get these different type of alkaloids. So this is the reaction scheme. Then they have discussed about the cycloaddition reactions of piperine. Then again the reaction data. So the same reaction they have carried out with different 13 types of solvents and different conditions as well. And they got and different type of yields. And they have already mentioned in the table 6 and table 7. And whatever conclusion is there, again they have written everything. So to at least to read this paper, you need minimum 2, 3, 4, 5 days to only to understand what they have done. Okay, so try to recollect whatever you can, and that's expected from all of us. Okay, then the conclusion part. Conclusion is also not easy. Then experimental section. Same like last paper which we have did, the same experimental part is there. Then extraction and isolation, how they have proceed. Okay, and then the detail, again the spectroscopic data. Then the interconvergible, and then the supporting information also there. Means this paper is already, I think, in 11 or 12 pages paper, 13 pages paper, and now I will show you the supporting data as well. Okay. So I will share my screen. Yes. So see this supporting information, the same paper which is Journal of Organic Chemistry. This is the name of title, and they have given the all diagrams, all spectras, NMR, carbon-13, depth, quasi, HMBC, NOSI, and so on. See, you can see now diagrams. This is the correlation, this is selection NOSI, quasi NOSI. Okay, this is the NMR values. this is the actual spectra. You can see it. This is the actual spectra. Okay, means from this spectra only we have collected the all values. Okay, so this is the spectra. This is carbon 13 spectra. This is again DEPT. This is the DEPT of this carbon 13 spectra. This is quasi of the spectra. This is CHSHF of the spectra. This is all belongs to NMR spectroscopy. Then HMBC. This is NOGI. Okay. Which is all about the compound first. Now it will start with compound 2. Proton, this is carbon 13, this is DEPT, this is quasi, this is CHHFS, this one HMBC, this is NOGI, this is again compound 3. Okay, like that. Okay, this is the first, I would say, first compound, sorry, and the first supporting information. The second supporting information, again, there are HMR and so on. Okay. Just I will roll it out. Okay, so hope you understand to publish one paper, how much efforts we have to take as a researcher. Okay, and this paper will have the impact factor is more than 10. Okay, this is one thing. This is the third supporting information. Just at least I will roll in this paper. Fourth supporting information. Tired? If yes, I would be happy. Last supporting information. Okay, from 61, like this. Okay, so this is all about the one case study. So hope guys you understand how much important to write one article in Journal of Organic Chemistry, and let you know that Dr. Sharad Pasle has published at least 4 paper in Journal of Organic American Chemical Society, and my highest impact factor is more than 8 is there, and we have provided so many supporting information. One of my paper is almost 80 pages paper. So you can imagine how much efforts we have taken during our research. All right, so hope you will motivated through this case study, and those who are not sincere, they will demoralize also, who will take like these efforts and so on. So I don't know how the impact will affect on you, but this is our part of syllabus. So try to recollect as much as you can. And from tomorrow, we will start the section 1. And very soon, I will offer you the 1, 2, 3, at least 3 tests you can carry out by online. Right? So, any question? Pallavi, Megha, Mayuri, Kuldeep, Pooja, Pallavi, Sandhya, Shubhangi, Smita, Supriya, Trupti,